Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Christmas ribbon salad, and it's my favorite Christmas salad. I make it every single year. We start with our Jell-O, the cherry Jell-O, and I need 3 cups of boiling water. So you probably saw that was boiling on the stove, and you can use the sugared Jell-O, but I decided use the sugar-free, and I'm going to make all of this as low fat and as low sugar as possible. But if you want to do it in the regular fashion, just follow the instructions and use regular materials. So you can use the regular Jell-O 3-ounce box. It's a small box, but you need 2 of them. I'm using the sugar-free, and I use 2 of them into 3 cups of boiling water. And in this case, we have a glass dish that can be used for serving, and this is an 8 by 12 by 2, something about that size. It doesn't have to be perfectly that size, but when you get your red Jell-O, it could be strawberry, raspberry also. I'm using cherry. When you get your red layer ready, excuse me, then just slowly and gently pour that in the bottom. And I did spray this. You can probably tell it. I sprayed it with some cooking oil spray. It was just canola oil. And the reason for that is that it will help the gelatin to come out a little easier when I serve it. So my goal at this point is just to have 1 layer of red Jell-O. So I'm going to let this sit here for a while, then I'll cover it with some plastic wrap. I'll put it in the refrigerator, and then I'll continue on this tomorrow. So you'll never notice a difference in the time, but for me, it's going to be overnight, and then I'll continue on this recipe. My cherry Jell-O has chilled overnight, and you can see here it is, and it's very stiff. The layer that goes on top of this has some lemon Jell-O, and I've got my water boiling. This is 1.5 cups of water. And I've chosen sugar-free again, but you could choose regular. It would be a small package. This is a 0.3-ounce size because of being sugar-free. I think the regular packages are 3 ounces that have the sugar in them. So just go ahead and put the lemon gelatin in there and dissolve it right in this pan where I boiled the water. So it just takes a minute or so to stir that around and get it dissolved. And I'll just explain to you what I'm going to do in the next step. I'm going to be pouring this into a large bowl, and then I'm going to be putting some cream cheese in with it. Now here you have some cream cheese that I've chosen the fat-free variety. I'm trying to keep this really low in calorie for some of you that are interested in that, but you can use regular. You only need 3 ounces. This is an 8-ounce container, and I didn't have anything other than 8-ounce containers, so I just cut off 3 ounces, and then I could bring it to room temperature, but I was kind of rushing this morning, so I just microwaved it a little bit to make sure that I could mash it down, because we're going to dissolve it in with the Jell-O. So I think this is ready. I'm going to pour this in the bowl. So it's nice smooth Jell-O, and any residue remains there in the pot. And then our cream cheese goes in. That's 3 ounces of softened cream cheese. And when it hits that boiling Jell-O mixture, then it's going to be able to be mixed up very easily. So we'll take our spoon here and get as much of that cream cheese as we can, and then just start stirring this around. At the end of this step, you're going to have a milky looking lemon Jell-O. So this gets wrapped with some kind of plastic wrap and put in the refrigerator along with this, and then we'll come back and continue this step and put it on top of the first layer, and eventually we'll have 3 layers. I have had my lemon Jell-O cream cheese mixture in the refrigerator for about 45 minutes, And you can see the consistency. You do not want it to gel up. I can see places in there where it's beginning to gel, so this is just about right. You want to be able to stir it around like this, but you certainly don't want it warm. You don't want it at room temperature. It needs to be in the refrigerator and cooled. Then we can whip some cream and blend that in. This is just a half pint of whipping cream. And I have put it in the freezer, actually. I stuck it in about the same time that went in the refrigerator. And you can see that it's got some chunks in here, but that's good. When you're whipping cream, it will whip much better for you if it's very cold. And very cold includes having some ice crystals. Now, you don't want it solid, because you wouldn't be able to get it out of here and you wouldn't be able to use your mixer on it. And I'm just using a hand mixer here. And this is 1/2 pint or 1 cup. So I've got all of that out and I'm going to be doing this for a little bit. It's going to be noisy, so I'll go away when this is whipped up nice. I have my cream whipped until it's nice and stiff. You don't want to just do it to soft peaks because that won't hold. You don't want to go farther than this because you'll have butter. So what you're going to do is just turn this into your mixture of lemon Jell-O and cream cheese that is cold now, and you're going to fold it in. This is what your lemon layer looks like after you have put the cream cheese and whipped cream in it and got it folded in, and it's complete, so it's ready to go on top of the gelled, which has to be gelled hard, cherry Jell-O. I'll just show you what this looks like before it goes in the refrigerator, and it will gel up a bit because of the Jell-O, and then we will finish it up after this has had a chance to set. I have 2 layers of my Christmas ribbon salad in the refrigerator setting up, and there is a 3rd layer that I'm going to start right now. I have 1 cup of water, which is boiling, taking that off the heat, bringing it over here, and here's where our green color comes in. We have lime gelatin, and I'm using the sugar-free again. Feel free to use the sugar kind if you like to. Just combine the mix in 1 cup of boiling water. You know, normally it would be 2 cups, but not in this case. We will be adding something to this later on. But the first step in this last layer is to combine this until it is dissolved, and then just, I'm going to pour it in a bowl right here, and I'm going to chill it until it's the consistency of unbeaten egg whites. So I'll get that going and I'll be back with you to finish up this salad. Here are the 2 completed 1st layers of the Christmas ribbon salad. You can see the ribbon forming, color contrast. Now we're going to do the 3rd ribbon or 3rd layer, and we've already mixed up our lime gelatin. We've had that in the refrigerator and we just gel it to the point where it's the consistency of unbeaten egg whites. Actually, I let mine go a little past that. It doesn't really matter. I've made this scores of times. So it can be beyond that or shy of that, but somewhere near it. This is a 15 1/4 ounce can of crushed pineapple in its own juice. I don't like to buy it in heavy syrup. That just adds more sugar. You don't have to drain this. You just put juice and all in here. Remember, we only put 1 cup of boiling water for the gelatin. It normally takes 2 cups. And then you mix this around. Just pour it over the top. And if you want to pour down the center and then try to get the edges a little bit, you're going to be spreading it out anyway. Try to cover the whole top. But it's runny, so that doesn't, it's not a problem to just kind of shift it after you have put that on. It's very critical that you have the 2 layers ready and they are set. They're gelled and they can accept this liquid on top, because we're going to be gelling this up and have all 3 layers gelled when it's completed. Now, this is the look it has when it's completed. And once it's gelled, it's ready to serve. You can serve it just like that. You can take a spoon and dip into it. Of course, I'm not going to do that now because it's not gelled. But after it gels, it's ready to go. Or if you have it in a mold, You can unmold it, and it's beautiful. It has stripes, as you can see. There should be a red stripe and then kind of a cream color stripe and a green stripe at the top. You might want to serve this on a piece of lettuce. You can cut out a square and then put it on the lettuce. It's a beautiful salad.